Okay, controversial question here, but is planning for a vacation more fun than actually going on that vacation? Probably not, right? But if you are like me, you love that research planning phase of a trip. You like reading into your destination before you get there and knowing where to go, what to see, things to do, where to eat. All of that you enjoy because you want to have a general sense of what you're walking into. At least that's how I approach it. Now, some people like really rigid schedules and you like to plan your itinerary to the T. That is not me, but I like using tools that support giving myself a well-rounded view of what it is I might see when I get to my destination. For years, I've been using Google My Maps, and to date, my most popular video on YouTube day after day is this video I made 4 years ago about how to plan a road trip with Google My Maps. I have used Google My Maps for those last 4 or 5 years, creating maps for every vacation I've been on. And based on the feedback I've gotten from that video, a lot of people have found it to be a very useful tool, which makes me so excited because today I've had a company reach out to me called Blue Planit that created a Chrome extension called Travel Mapper that makes this process, what I've been doing, even more seamless. And that's why I'm so excited to share it with you guys, because I know you've benefited from Google My Maps in the past, and I'm excited to show you this add-on that can just help you even more in your trip planning phase. Okay, so I have just returned from a trip to Edinburgh, Scotland, and I used the Travel Mapper tool to plot out that whole trip. I have since deleted it so I can walk you guys through the whole process. So if you want to follow along, feel free to do so. You can jump into your Google Chrome. Make sure you're logged into your Gmail or Google account that you want to use, and visit blueplanit.co. Once you're here, you're going to install the Google Sheets add-on and the Chrome extension. You need both to get this whole thing working. And I already did that, so I'm not going to click into it. But once you do have that all installed, you will see this extension here, the Blue Planit extension here at the top. Now, if you don't see that, just come up to Window and Extensions, and you will see the option to add that on. And then it should appear here. All right, so once you see it there, you're gonna click it and you will see this nice little drop down to create a new itinerary. Give it a second. And what this is really doing is just creating a customized Google Sheet for you to work within or to add to. I will show you that in a second. So it's a template and we can see it here. If I click it, I can click edit. And you'll see if you create a bunch of them, you'll see them all here, but I'm just gonna click into this very first sheet. All right, pretty straightforward. We've got a couple of tabs down here, including an itinerary tab, a checklist, split costs, and backdoor stuff. So we're mostly gonna be in this itinerary tab, and we'll come back to that in a little bit. And like I said, if you're gonna be making multiple trips, which hopefully you are, hopefully you've got a lot of vacations planned, you're just gonna rename this at the top. So I'm gonna do Edinburgh, Scotland, 3-day trip, whatever, there we go. And you'll see if I go back to this extension over here that has renamed it. So when you click this drop down, you'll see the names of all of your vacations if you've named them. Cool. Okay. So you might be thinking, great, this is a Google Sheet. I could have made this myself. What is the special catch about it? We'll get into that shortly. But what I want to do is take you through how you probably normally research for your trip, which is just going to Google and learning about the location or maybe watching something on YouTube. But we'll start at Google. So I'm here in Google and I'm going to type things to do in Edinburgh. You can see that was my most recent search. So I'm here. I start reading. In the interest of time, I'm not actually going to read. I'm just going to select a couple of random things. So I've found this blog. Great. And I'm learning about Calton Hill. And it sounds very interesting. I think it might be something I want to see. All I'm going to do is, having trouble with my mouse here. All I'm going to do is highlight, which you can't really see very well on your end, but I'm highlighting the thing that's intriguing me and right clicking and hitting save Calton Hill to itinerary. And this pop-up occurs and you can add in whatever information you want. From this point, like, I don't really have too much information about it that I want to include other than category, but you can add costs. So let's say it was a $5 fee to explore Calton Hill. You want to add that category. I'll put landmark. And I don't know time. I really don't know the address. It just sounded like an interesting place I wanted to go. So I'm going to hit save. And I'll scroll down a little bit more and pick maybe two other spots. So we'll do, let's do the real Mary King's Close, something that I did. Boy, oh boy, my mouse is being wonky, but let's see if I right click that. Okay, that's fine. I don't even need to highlight. I'm just right clicking Mary King's Close, save. Category, this is an attraction, it's a tour. And I know, I don't remember the price, but I'm gonna say the tour was $29.99, let's say that. Save. And I saw there was a typo in what I highlighted, so I will fix that in a second, but let's go one more and say Arthur's Seat. This is a great place to hike in Edinburgh, so I'm going to add this. Let's see, is there a category for hiking? Well, we can go with outdoor or park in nature. There's a couple of different options there. It's free, so I'm not gonna put in any cost. Hit save. Great. Three things that caught my interest for things I could potentially do once I'm in Edinburgh. So I jump back to that sheet and there we go. Those three things are here. I'm gonna adjust that typo, Real Mary King's Close. And you can see it's divided into categories. Cost has a link from where I found that information. This is all from the same blog. And that's it. I didn't fill in anything else yet, but very cool that it's been automated directly to this spreadsheet. Now, what is the real feature of this program that is the most compelling to me? It's its ability to automatically create a map based on what I have right-clicked on. So it normally appears over here. If you're not seeing that, you want to come up here within the Google Sheet to Extensions and go to Travel Mapper and View Map. And give it a second. Amazing. I'm gonna expand this so you guys can see a little more clearly. Those are my three locations that I just dropped into my Google Sheet. They are now on a map. They're numbered in order. That doesn't really matter to me at this point, but you'll see how that can be helpful shortly. And yeah, they seem pretty accurate. They're all within Edinburgh. I did experiment earlier and I selected a restaurant and apparently the restaurant was a chain. So when I right-clicked the restaurant name, it dropped a pin somewhere in London. So if you find that the address is incorrect where it dropped it in, you can come over to the location tab and actually edit it yourself. You can also choose to not have it display on your map if you don't want it to. So let's go add a couple more things, maybe accommodations, where to stay in Edinburgh. Great. Let's say the Scotsman Hotel was intriguing. And notice I'm just working within Google. I can click into the website directly if I wanted to, or I can just highlight right from Google. Scotsman Hotel sounds like a great place to stay. Save. Maybe it's $600 for the weekend. I'll put that as lodging. There we go. And again, I'm not gonna bother with the address at this point. As we saw, it can be automated using this tool. Drop there, lodging, and let's do something for food. Where to eat. All right, I love Rick Steves, so let's jump into Rick Steves' forum here. This person loves the Muscle Inn. Maybe I will too, right click it. Cost, we're not gonna add a cost. Who knows how much I'm gonna eat there. And we'll just select the category food. Great. Okay, so we have a couple things here. I'm not gonna go through a complete comprehensive list for Edinburgh, but you can see the general trend of you're reading about these things, whether it's on a blog or you're watching a YouTube video, you're learning about these things that you can do at your destination and just casually dropping them into your spreadsheet here. And at the same time, the spreadsheet is updating. Actually, I'm sorry, it doesn't automatically update. You wanna hit update map for the map to update, but the spreadsheet is automatically updating as you are dropping things in from your Google search. Oh boy, option number five is showing up way across the world, so that's probably incorrect. What I'm gonna do is look at the address here. New Zealand, definitely not. So let's do Muscle in Edinburgh. And I'm gonna grab that address, right-click it, copy. This probably would have been the better way to pin that or to save it, to send it to my spreadsheet is to go to the actual tab for the restaurant in Edinburgh, and it would have accurately depicted the address there. But that's okay. I just messed up on that front, so I'm gonna delete that, paste, great, and update the map, and that should go back to Scotland. There we go, perfect. Another thing I want to point out while we're here is this category area where you can customize the categories that are featured there. So we have a bunch to choose from already, but if you want to make your own categories, you just hit this edit button and then you come down here to add another item, or you can adjust any of these above, but we'll do an add item here. We'll add airports and you can hit done, apply to all. And then as far as color coding, if you want the colors to be different on the map itself, you know, you can get as specific as you want. You can come up to format and then conditional formatting. And you'll see the colors that are designated per category right now. You can change those colors just by clicking into them and changing the color here with the fill. Or because we just created a new category, airport, I'm gonna add a rule for that. So I'm gonna go from J4 to J368, I think that's what the rest of them are, maybe. I'm gonna just highlight all of the rows here in this column. If that is equal to airports, then I want the color to be bright yellow. Done. Perfect. And then you can close out of that. So let's say for whatever reason the Scotsman Hotel was actually an airport. I can come here, hit airports, and that should be good to go. And if I hit update map, should reflect that change. There we go. Great, so now the numbers, the colors, all very helpful, all very visual, but let's add a couple more things. So I have exhausted myself with learning about Edinburgh. I think I've listed everything here that I wanna see, what I wanna do, but let's get more specific. And by the way, I should back up a second. You don't have to get more specific than this. This is probably where I would end personally, because this is all I want on a vacation. I just wanna see things I can do in the area. I don't want to plan to the T and to the time when I'm going to do these things. But if you are that person, or if there are things that do require a schedule, maybe there's a tour happening only at one time, you want to make sure that is noted here. So there is a use case for that. And that's what I'm going to share with you now. But again, you don't have to go much further than this if you don't want to. This is great in just laying out your potential trip. But let's say you have some dates and times here. So we'll say this is coming up, 9 a.m. And maybe the same thing, Wednesday. Let's do this at 11. And we'll make this one for Thursday. I'll type it here, Thursday. Don't necessarily have a time for that. And this is a hotel, so I don't know how to do a range here, but I'll just say that, oh, actually, let's do it the 11th when I arrive in Scotland. And I won't add anything for the muscle in. I don't really know when I'll be able to do that. But the reason why I'm showing you this and all the other information you can fill out is because now if I come up here, I can go to edit trip. And if you're familiar with Trello, or I think it's Microsoft Planner, this is a similar interface where you can actually drag and drop things and add information wherever you see fit. So this is a great visual of how your week or so is going to be laid out, and you can move things around. So let's say you've originally had 9 a.m. for Calton Hill, but actually it's probably going to be better for you to visit on Thursday. You can drop that in here, hit save, and that will update not only in this view, but also, let's see, so this is Thursday. Let's see if that updated. Calton Hill, it's now at Thursday. And it also changes the order here, so it changes the numbers that are listed here. Everything is connected. It's such a seamless system. Genius, really. It seems super basic, but really it has all of those elements that capture your entire trip. So again, I got here by hitting edit trip. And I can customize my plan even further. Now, the really cool feature of this section is you can email your itinerary. So if you're traveling with friends or family, or you just want a copy for yourself, you can email that out. The other part that is going to connect us back to Google My Maps is you can export your map to Google My Maps directly from this. So that's probably your last step that you want to do. Once you have everything ironed out here, you would go into Edit Trip and hit Export to Google My Maps, which we'll do shortly. I haven't actually done that yet today, so we'll do it in a moment, but I just wanted to show you one more feature here, which is actually a couple things in this map area. First, you can sort or you can filter out things. If you only want to see your food options, you can uncheck everything else and just see what you've labeled for food. You can bring them all back if you want. Whatever view you want, you can adjust right there. Also, we've been looking at Google to get all of our information for what we want to do on this trip, but you can add a place. So let's say you were chatting with a friend and they said, oh, you know what? You really need to visit the Royal Yacht Britannia. You can type it in here without even finding a link to it on Google. There you go. It searches Google essentially, and it brings you all the information for that. You're going to hit save and you'll see it adds to the map and it will add to your trip itinerary, and you can make adjustments here on the fly. Let's just go one step further and actually create the Google My Maps version of this. So we have everything listed here. We have our map generated here. Going into Edit Trip, maybe we've already emailed our itinerary out to our friends and family. Now we want to come here to export to Google My Maps. So this is going to create a file that you will then import to Google My Maps. Let's do that here. Great, I'm going to go back to Google My Maps. I already have my Edinburgh trip that I built previously, but let's go here, create. This brings you a blank Google My Map sheet and or map, I should say. You want to just click import, B, drag and drop it in. And boom, there you go. So just like we saw here, let's go back. Just like this map, we now have it in Google My Maps. You can rename it. I'll just do Edinburgh Test. And you might be thinking this is a little redundant, but the feature of Google My Map that you will be using is accessing this on your phone. So you are going to go to your Google Maps app on your phone, saved, make sure you're logged into your correct Gmail account, Maps, and there it is, Edinburgh Test. You can zoom out, all those pinned items are still there, all the same categories are there. And you have your complete trip at your disposal, whether it's through the itinerary sent to your email or through this Google My Map right on your phone. So everything is in the palm of your hand. You can relax, enjoy your vacation, and share with the others that might be traveling with you. So thank you so much to Blue Planit for reaching out in the first place and partnering with me on this video. I always enjoy looking into tools that help with the vacation planning. So this has been a real joy to explore what you guys have created. I hope it's helped my audience. I'm sure there'll be a lot of people getting some use out of it. And if you are one of those people, feel free to click the link in my description. It's an affiliate link. I'll get a little kickback from it, but more importantly, you'll get to explore a tool that I think will be really, really helpful to you for your vacations. So yeah, let me know if you found it useful, what you've used it for, and until next time, thank you so much for watching.